Hey everybody, welcome back to my channel. So I thought I would do a demo today of this Monopop eyeshadow palette that I recently hauled from the face shop, Avon the face shop, and also the blush, the moisture cushion blush in red. I got these the other day in a video, or you know, I showed them in an unboxing and I thought I would play with them. I have used them both before. The blush was a little intense, so this time I'm going to try to do my best to scale it back a little bit. But the eyeshadow was really, really pretty. So what I currently have, I've already started my face. What I currently have on is my Ink Lasting Foundation from Avon the Face Shop. I have on my Avon concealer, the one that got discontinued. Now remember, we do have a new concealer line coming up soon, so I'll be trying that for sure. And then I also have on my contouring stick, the transforming contouring stick in the shade Light, and I have on the lip in Fluffy Pink. That's the Flat Velvet lipstick in the Fluffy Pink shade. I really like it. It's pretty. I like it better than I thought I would. I was like afraid that it would be too light or something and I wouldn't like it, but I actually, it has a little bit more depth and it's not quite as just pink as I thought it would be. And I do have the Beyond Color lip conditioner on underneath of it. I go through these frequently. I love these. I always wear them underneath everything. So I'm not powdered yet, which is why I look kind of shiny, because I'm going to start off with the moisture cushion blush in the red color. And like I said, I wore it the other day and it was a little intense. I put it on in the same method that I use the pink one and the coral one, and I just think I gave it a little too much. So I'm gonna go a little bit lighter this time. I'm gonna try to I'm gonna show you what it looks like again. See, it's really, really bright. And with this type of video, not doing the live, before I showed it in the live, you can't really, everything looks a little washed out with my camera. But when I film with this camera, you can see the color a little bit better. So we're going to try, I might zoom in just a tad. I'm not going to zoom in like a big ton, but just a little bit there. And let me... Let me see. Get my mirror where I want it to be. Okay, so yeah, I'm just going to go ahead and I'm going to take my brush that I applied my foundation with, and I'm just going to kind of lightly press it in. The other day I pressed it in, I think, too much. So this is what I got, that much. So I'm going to really try to just lightly. Yeah, that's better. The other day I had, like, I really put it in. Let me put my mirror down there. So I had like a lot on, and it's still pretty, you know, significant, but you can really blend it around. I like using the brush. I have more control this way. But I think it's really pretty. It's just a beautiful shade. So I'm going to go ahead and do it again. Where the other one, give myself a little bit more. Hopefully I didn't get too much. So when I did get too much the other day, I just kept blending and blending and blending and blending and blending. And then by the time I got done and then I applied my powder over it, it really wasn't too much. I also already did my brows, as you can tell. Let me move my mirror. I'm going to move it a little bit here. I'm trying to make them even. The afternoon light is coming in. And so I have shadow on this side of my face, and it's hard to make sure that I have everything even. Might put just the tiniest bit more. Now on your end, you're probably like, don't do that. Don't add any more. I can't tell. And at first I was like, you know what? The day has gotten away from me. I'm just going to scrap it and not do anything. But that is not the attitude to have, right? Just forge ahead and do the best I can. So, okay. There you go. I just really love these blushes. They're beautiful. They're beautiful. So don't be scared by this color. It is intense, but just don't be afraid. And then I'm going to follow it up with the Moisture Cushion Highlight, which I'm always bragging on, right? And I'm going to go ahead and just use my same foundation brush. That's how I like to apply it. And I'm just going to kind of go along there. This highlight is so beautiful. I love it so much. Put a little bit here. The tip of my nose. Go ahead and do the other side. We're doing laundry, so if you hear that going, that's what that is. I just love this blush, or this highlight. I do. I really do. So then I'm going to go ahead and powder now. And my powder is just my Ben Nye Pretty Pink that I wear. So yeah, I was really, when I used the that Mono Pop eyeshadow the other day, it came out really pretty, the look that I did. So I was really pleased with it. It is Saturday afternoon here, and it's super sunny. My plan was to get all dressed up, and I was going to do some videos, and instead I did take a shower, but I didn't wash my hair, and I'm wearing a Red Wings t-shirt and my pajama bottoms. But I was like, maybe we can just salvage the day in some way. Plus, when I do the, when I showed these two products, the eyeshadow palette and the, that blush in the live video, like I said, they were washed out. So I wanted you to see that they, you know, what they really look like, more true to color. So I've already primed my eyelids, and we'll go ahead and open the eyeshadow palette. And there is a mirror in here, which is good. And this is what the shadows look like. Now, so you can really see them more in this light than you could in the live. So there you go. Hopefully it's not quite as reflective. So I'm going to go ahead and try using this middle shade here as a transition shade, and then I'm going to use this deeper shade up top here in the crease. I was asked Keith today, it was so funny, I said, do you think your eyebrows are growing faster than they did before? And he goes, no, why? Do they look bad? I was like, no. But I said, I started using that clinical eye lift again, and I feel like my eyebrows are really growing, like, quickly. And I've been using it on him, too. He's been using it. And so he was like, no, I don't feel like that. So I said, well, just pay attention and start, thinking about if your eyebrows, I'm going to move my mirror up a little bit. If your eyebrows are growing more rapidly than they normally do. Because I was like, that gel for the top part, you know, I don't know. It just seems kind of, I feel like my eyebrows are getting long quicker. Of course, that's not any kind of a scientific claim from Avon or anything like that, that the clinical eye lift makes your eyebrows grow. And then I'm going to just blend it out a little bit. Buff it. When in doubt, blend it out. Isn't that what they say? Okay. And then I'm going to take, like I said, that deeper shade in the top corner there. and I'm going to use that in the crease. And also, I think I'm going to put it on the outer edge of the lid. Wait, is that the one I'm going to use? Yes. Just checking. I have, today is Saturday, and I have an Avon meeting Monday, and I'm really looking forward to going because I didn't go to the January one, because that's when I was so sick, and so I wasn't able to go to that one, and I really miss my Avon meetings when I don't go. I miss them, like, terribly, you know. I like my Avon friends. We get along, and we provide each other with good motivation and support, and I just really enjoy spending time with my Avon girls and guys. One guy, when I had the opportunity. And so I'm definitely looking forward to going. Plus, it gives me an excuse to kind of get dressed up and done up and everything. You know, we usually go out to a restaurant, and I think this time it's at the Big Boy. So we're going to have that meeting, and I'm looking forward to it for sure. I haven't been getting out too much. We went to my mom's yesterday and took her out to Cracker Barrel, and picked up her prescriptions. So that was my big day yesterday. We're not able to get out like we used to be, and I miss it, but it's something that has to be for right now, and I'm okay with that. But it's nice to kind of, you know, get done up and go out, even if it's just like to run errands or, you know, go out for lunch somewhere, whatever. The movies, we used to go to the movies a lot. We haven't been to the movies in quite a while, and it's all right, you know. But like today, I was just gonna get dressed up and for the heck of it and do some videos and some pictures outside since it's so sunny of some of my, I have a couple dresses from Torrid I was going to take some pictures of and a blouse, and then it didn't happen. So that's okay though. You just got to learn to roll with it. This is our new normal. Just roll with it and make the best of what you can and enjoy it. Find something enjoyable about the day. Count your blessings, right? I'm going to buff it out a little. I think I told you I already had my eyelids primed. So I've had a few questions about foundation, because people had stocked up on the True Color Flawless foundation before it got discontinued, and some people are running now low, you know. Yeah, I have a few people that did that, and they were asking me about the foundation. And I honestly believe that this Ink Lasting is very close in formula and coverage to the Ideal Flawless. So I was thinking about doing a video with one side where I do my Ideal Flawless and then one side using this, so that you can see the difference in like the coverage and how it applies and stuff like that. The shades are a little bit different, but the basic formula still, you know, you'll be able to get a feel for that. So that's an idea I have for an upcoming. So now I'm gonna pick, I want to do, let's just do this really pretty shimmer shade here. Kind of a sparkly one. Oops, don't want to drop it. So we'll try that and see how that looks on the lid. Oh, very pretty. It's not super intense. I bet you if I use my finger, it might be, but we'll try to build it up a little. There we go. Kind of like a peachy champagne type shade. Nice. And the weather is so pretty today. And I think it's supposed to be pretty this whole weekend. And then they say that we're going to get next week, like Wednesday and Thursday, is like rain and snow mix. Just when you think that spring has sprung, right? But it's too early for spring. That's for sure. Usually we always have like a big snow or an ice storm around my birthday. And that's mid-March. So, yeah. I knew. It's a fooler. And then I want to find something to put down in the lower lash line. Let's do this middle shade right here. This one. We'll try that. Ooh, that's pretty. So I used, like I said, I used this palette once, and then today is my second time using it, and I have no complaints about it. I think it seems well. It blends nice. There's good color payoff. There's no issues with it, you know. Very nice. I'm going to pick up the coral one, too. I don't know. I didn't order it yet. I actually placed another Avon order the other day, and it came this morning. And it's unusual for me to place an order 2 weeks in a row, but I had a reason to. And I'll show you guys what I got with that in that order. I'll do an unboxing. I have my Cosmic Brown Glimmerstick here. Yeah, my hair. I should have done something with it. But this is about the makeup, not the hair. And actually, guess what? I'm at the end of my Glimmerstick. It won't twist up anywhere, so all I've got left is that much. I think I have a backup. If I don't, I'll get another one. I've gone through many of these. And I'm just tight lining the upper and lower waterline. Yesterday, or the day I used it before, I used that Raisin Glimmer Stick and it, with this palette, and it looked really pretty. But I don't have that one. It's in my other makeup bag, the Raisin one. So we're watching The Irishman on Netflix. We started it last night. We split it up because we started watching it late in the day. It was probably like 9:30 at night when we started watching it. And we could have been pretty early these days. But we did stay up last night and watch the first half of it. And I think we'll finish it tonight. But it's pretty good. Interesting, anyways, whether or not it's, you know, true. I know it's based on supposedly true accounts, but sometimes those criminals like to glorify themselves a little bit. So I don't know if it is or not. Jimmy Hoffa, though, and I live in the Detroit area, which I'm sure most of you guys already know, and Jimmy Hoffa lore is, like, legendary here. I mean, everybody knows Jimmy Hoffa tales. And where I lived before I moved here to the city, before I met Keith, I lived out in the country about an hour out of the Detroit area, and a very small town and very rural farming area. And we always had about once every couple years, around the time usually of Jimmy Hoffa's disappearance, like the anniversary of it, there would be some local farmer that would be having to get one of his fields dug up by the FBI doing a search because someone had left a tip that Jimmy Hoffa's remains were going to be in that field. And it was very common for that to happen. So I'm just blending that in down here, smudging it about. Plus, there's always, like, a fascination with the mafia, even though they're, like, super criminals, you know what I mean? Like, I don't know, there's always just a kind of, like, a romanticized version of it, and I know that there's really nothing romantic about crime and criminals, and they're terrible people, and they do these awful things, but in the movies, they always, I'm sorry, I'm flipping my mirror down here so I can get a, put my mascara on, which is the Love at First Lash mascara. There's always like a romanticized version, you know, like the Sopranos. I was a huge Sopranos fan. And Tony Soprano was a great character, but he was a horrible person, you know, like I realized he was fiction. But I mean, he was like a horrible character, you know, responsible for all these murders and mayhem and everything like that and all this crime. But yet the show, you know, kind of gave him a little bit of a charm, right? And so you kind of, you're kind of like enamored of this character that's a bad guy, but yet he's our bad guy and we've kind of fallen for him a little bit, you know? It's funny how they're able to do that. I know that they have started, I read an article not long ago about the, it was like 25 films we're most looking forward to seeing in 2020. And one of them was The Saints of Newark, I think is going to be the name of it. And it's the prequel to The Sopranos. And I am so looking forward to that. I'm really looking forward to that. I think they said it's supposed to be out. Oops. Oops. I don't think I have a Q-tip either. I got a smudge right there. I got a tissue, but I don't know if I'll be able to get it. I think I got it. I know they said it's going to be out, I think, November of this year. And I really, really, really am looking forward to watching that. Like, really bad. I don't know if I could watch The Sopranos. I used to have them on DVD, like, the whole series. And then I sold them in a yard sale that we had. Because I didn't think I wanted to watch them ever again. And sometimes I regret doing that because I really liked that show. But right now I'm at a stage in my life where I cannot stand excessive cursing. It drives me nuts. Like, I understand that sometimes they use the F word in movies. Sometimes I use the F word. Not very often though, not anymore, but occasionally, I'm not going to lie. I get particularly worked up about something, that F word might come out, but, I can't stand movies or TV shows that have excessive use of it, where it's not even, like, necessary. It's completely gratuitous, and it's just there to be there. And they swear a lot in The Sopranos, if you've never watched it before. But, so I don't know if I could take that, you know? I don't know if it would irritate me to the point where I couldn't watch the show. I don't know what my deal is. I keep getting mascara on my lids. I apologize about that. And if I edited it, that's when and I'm talking about the F word, I'd be like, I keep getting the beep and mascara on my bleep and lids. No, I wouldn't. So, yeah, I don't know. But I'm looking forward to seeing that movie regardless, and I'm definitely going to go watch it. Keith never watched The Sopranos. I think he probably has seen an episode here and there, but he never watched, like, the whole series like I did. And I really, really liked it. And I can remember, like, when certain things happened. And The Sopranos is so, I mean, it's been on for so long. I don't want to give spoilers or anything like that. But if you have never watched The Sopranos and you plan on doing it someday, then stop listening to me. Turn the volume down. Mute me or something. But, like, certain things on that show really, really got to me. Like, when Adriana got murdered, when they took her out, it really, really disturbed me. I mean, I wasn't shocked by it, because, like, I knew that she had it coming, you know? Snitches get stitches, hello? But I don't know. I was like, did she really think that, you know, that Christopher was gonna run off with her and go into witness protection? Because, you know, I'm like, she should have known better, you know? Women are a dime a dozen in those kind of movies to the gangsters and everything. And his loyalty was definitely with, you know, his gang and Tony and everything. And I particularly when she got in the car, you know, when the guy picked her up, and now I can't remember his name, Stevie Van Zandt, you know, the guy, when he picked her up in the car, I was like, girl, no. It just, I don't know, it really, and then the way how they didn't show it happened, but you heard it happen off camera, that like the gunshot that got to me. It really bothered me. I don't know. But I liked that show a lot. I liked it quite a bit. So yeah, in The Godfather, I love The Godfather. I love Godfather 1 and 2. Godfather 3 is a travesty and sucks totally, but I love 1 and 2. They were showing The Godfather movies on AMC recently, and I watched them a couple days in a row. Even though cut for television, I just really, really like The Godfather movies. I like 2 better than 1, but yeah. I think I need to get another one of these. This one's starting to get a little bit... I like this mascara a lot, but I think this one's starting to get a little clumpy. Because I've had it for a while. So it's getting dry. Well, and then I meant to grab my cucumber facial mist, and I forgot. So I won't use that one. Take the zoom back out here. I have another one, though. Let's see, which one do I want to use? I finished my MAC one. Well, I got this one. Let me grab it. This is the NYX Dewy Finish, which I really don't think I need any Dewy Finish, but I'll use it. I finished up my one Smashbox, or not Smashbox, my MAC Coconut one. So, just going to give this a little bit of a mist. Hopefully my mascara is dry enough. I always use a setting spray, so. But I've really been liking that Wet n Wild cucumber one. Really, really nice. But that's it, you guys. I don't know. I mean, what do you think? I thought that it performed really, really well. Just like a basic, everyday eye. You know, nothing super exciting or whatever. I'll do another layer of the lipstick, and I'll swatch it for you guys. So this is the Fluffy Pink again. It's really pretty. Really, really pretty, I think. So I have 2 more of the Flat Velvets in the order that came this morning. I have Scarlet Red and In the Moment, I think. And then I'll be done with the collection except for Solar Beige. That's the only one now that I don't have. So I don't know. I had that order to do. I was going to film an unboxing. I don't know if I'm going to or not because the light's getting weird. But we'll see. Maybe I'll do it anyways. We could try it and see what happens. But I definitely need to do something with my hair first. But I thought since I, you know, didn't have anything else going on, I would show you guys. So this was the Monopop eyeshadow from Avon Face Shop. And the blush was the Moisture Cushion blush in the red. And I'll leave product numbers for everything in the description section below, as well as a link to where you can shop my e-store if you are so inclined to do that. But none of this stuff that I use today is limited edition or anything like that. So it's all available except, like I showed you that I use that concealer and that's not available any longer. But everything else is good to go. So let me know what you guys think. I think it's a great little palette. It's a nice little neutral palette. It's always good to have a neutral palette in your arsenal. I believe that firmly. I think that this, you know, that it's a necessary thing that everybody needs to have. And I love color, but I have learned that having a neutral palette in your collection is invaluable to you, especially if you love color, because you need something to ground those colors, you know. You need something to bring them down a notch, you know, so to speak. So thank you guys so much for watching. I appreciate listening to my rambling, and I will see you soon in another video for sure. Have a great weekend.